Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, let us collect ourselves once again and give thanks to God for this day and prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Give to all sinners, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Who are sent to heal the God's heart of heart, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We invite to God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to eternal life.
Amen.
Let us pray.
O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Amaziah, the priest of Bethel, sent word to Jeroboam, king of Israel. Amos has conspired against you here within Israel. The country cannot endure all his words. For this is what Amos says: Jeroboam shall die by the sword, and Israel shall surely be exiled from its land. To Amos, Amaziah said, off with you, missionary, flee to the land of Judah. There, earn your bread by prophesying, but never again prophesy in Bethel. For it is the king's sanctuary and the royal temple. Amos answered Amaziah, I was no prophet, nor have I belonged to a company of prophets. I was a shepherd and a dresser of sycamores. The Lord took me from following the flock and said to me, go prophesy to my people Israel. Now hear the word of the Lord. You say, prophesy not against Israel, preach not against the house of Isaac. Now thus says the Lord, your wife shall be made a harlot in the city, and your sons and daughters shall fall by the sword. Your land shall be divided by measuring line, and you yourself shall die in an unclean land. Israel shall be exiled far from its land. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just.
The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just.
The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The decree of the Lord is trustworthy, giving wisdom to the simple.
The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just.
The precepts of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The command of the Lord is clear, enlightening the eye. The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just. The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The ordinances of the Lord are true, all of them just. The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just. They are more precious than gold, than a heap of purest gold.
sweeter also than syrup or honey from the cow. The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just.
It's that from the gospel.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. After entering the boat, Jesus made a crossing and came into his own town. And there were people brought to him, paralytic, lying on a stretcher. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, "Courage, child, your sins are forgiven." At that, some of the scribes said to themselves, "This man is blaspheming." Jesus knew what they were thinking and said, "Why do you harbor evil thoughts? Which is easier to say, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Rise and walk'? But that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins," he then said to the paralytic, "Rise, pick up your stretcher, and go home." He rose and went home. When the crowd saw this, they were struck with awe and glorified God, who had given such authority to them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
We continue to hear from the Gospel of Matthew this section where we not only hear Jesus proclaiming the kingdom of God, but now it's in different actions that personify him as the king. And so yesterday we heard about an exorcism, and today we heard about his healing that begins with forgiveness. Jesus, although the man could not move, he was paralyzed. The very first thing Jesus notices is the heart. And he says, "Your sins are forgiven." Forgiveness comes first. That's the thing that Jesus notices, and first action is to heal the soul. This man who was paralyzed, then he restores the health to his body, the movement to his limbs. He begins with that forgiveness, which then leads to that other healing, physical healing. And it all started because he was brought, people brought to him a paralytic lying on a stretcher. The other version of the Luke's Gospel that talks about how he had to open the roof and lower him because there were so many people in the house. Matthew doesn't give us those details, but we know still that he could not come on his own. He was brought by others. And that's something that we can do for one another. We can help one another by our prayers. Praying for each other is to bring each other to God, to bring each other to Jesus, the King who heals, who forgives, who restores. And we can be like these people who brought Aramaic and could not come himself by praying. That's what we can do. That's the best thing we can do, is pray for others who maybe have lost their faith, or maybe are going through
moments of great doubt and just go into that dark time, and bring them to the Lord by our prayers. That's something that in that way we help each other. In that way we help each other be part of the kingdom of God with Jesus, our loving King. So let us stand and offer our petitions to God, bringing the needs of people who need our prayers ourselves and the world, our community, our church. We offer these masks for Chester and Ruth Baker, and they may rest in peace. Let us pray to the Lord. And for John Burke, for his intentions, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Trusting that nothing is impossible for God, present our needs. That the Lord may keep watch over his church, growing her in holiness and virtue, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the peace of Christ may heal divisions and bring an end to violence throughout the world, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the compassion and mercy of Christ may free all who suffer from any physical or spiritual burden, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Holy Spirit may help us live faithfully our commitment to the teachings of Jesus, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for healing both in the heart around this country and also physical healing those who are sick, and for an end to the pandemic, let us pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, hear our prayers and answer them in your bounteous love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
The Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all.
O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, Christ humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we proclaim the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim, Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Robert, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you for your Son, Jesus Christ. In him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. In this divine sacrifice we have offered and received, fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With
your spirit. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We go in the peace of Christ.
Amen. Amen.